1 Adam 12, 1 Adam 12, a 415 man with a gun. 1 Adam 12, no warrant. Lincoln X-ray, item 483. 1 Adam 12, a 415 fight group with chains and knives.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Richard's Toy Room. Today we're doing another plastic model kit review. We're going to go over this Ford Interceptor police car. So let's start off with looking at the box. As you can see, it's got the classic art, probably from the very first release of this kit. Here's the side. They show a Chevy police car as well. Now, I have not seen that kit, vintage or new, and I don't know if they plan on releasing that one or not, but I definitely would build that one as well to have them side by side. Although, actually, looking at it being red, I'm not sure it's actually an actual police car. Maybe like a fire chief or something. But either way, it's a municipality vehicle. And the ends are the same as the box top as they usually are in AMTs. But on the side, they do show you, you know, some of the features that are in the kit, like the light bar and the, you know, the Interceptor engine, yada yada. So I did take a look at this kit beforehand, and it's not a high parts count kit, and it is the typical, rather primitive AMT release from this time period. It has the really cheapy kind of wheels that were like on a toy car, which basically this looks like it was probably one of the promo cars of the time. It has that same look and feel to it that a lot of the AMT kits of these cars do from the time period. So anyway, but I mean, that doesn't mean it's a bad kit. So let's take a look at the paperwork that's in the kit first, and then we'll look at the instructions, and then we'll get to the parts. Well, since this is on top, we'll look at the decals. You got a real nice decal sheet here. You've got State Police, Chicago Police, Highway Patrol, and the City of Troy, Michigan Police, which if I'm not mistaken, I believe that's where the model company was originally back in the day. So that was their kind of in-joke, I guess, if you want to call it that. But a lot of nice decals on here. Not a whole lot of like stripes or anything, unless you use the Chicago one, but you do have like the door emblems and stuff. So I'm intending, at least at this point, on doing the New York State Police, mostly because that's the state where I grew up, and my father is actually a retired New York State Trooper. So I'm kind of want to do a New York State Trooper car from the era. The only problem is I haven't been able to find, at least not yet, I'm going to do a little bit more research before I get to the painting, I haven't been able to find a whole lot of photos of vehicles from that time period, mostly because I want to do the paint scheme the same, and I don't know what parts, because they're blue and kind of like school bus yellow. You know, yeah, I don't know what parts were yellow and what parts were blue. So I'm having a little hard time finding vehicles, and I especially haven't found one of these Fords in a State Trooper, New York State Trooper car that I can copy the paint scheme from. So I may end up having to either just copy whatever I can find out there and just, you know, make my own fantasy version of it, or maybe go with a different car. I don't know. I haven't decided at this point. Anyhow, let's get on with it here. So this kit must have been sitting around for a while, because this has a 2013 Round 2 Models catalog in it. No really need to go through that. Also, your Round2Models.com, join the Round 2 Model mailing list and get our email newsletter. And as I usually like to say, welcome to the 80s. And then this little box thing that they you can create your little mini version of the full-size box. I don't build these. I think they're kind of dumb. And I've been stacking them up, and I'll probably just sell them all on eBay one of these days. So here's your instruction sheet. It's not a whole lot to it. There's four pages. So it starts out with your engine as usual, and typical engine parts count there. Moves on to your wheels and tires. Now you also have the option on this kit, although they don't show it in here, you can use the blanking plug and just build a, glue the hood shut or whatever, and just build a roller model so it doesn't have an actual engine in it. But I don't see the sense in doing that. If you give you the engine, I won't build it. So they give you metal axles, and here's your interior. Not a whole lot to that. They don't give you a divider between the front and rear seat, so I'm not sure exactly if, I know all cop cars don't have that, but it seems like usually that's a typical thing that you would find in a cop car and a cop car model. But anyhow, so they give you all these little things you put in there, like the shotgun and fire extinguisher and your spotlight and your radio. Obviously too old to have a computer. Not a whole lot here in the step, I guess that's step four. Third page, radiator, firewall, interior, one-piece interior glass, and the mirror. Pop that onto the assembled interior. And then throw your hood, your light bar, and your bumpers on, antenna, mirrors, screw it together, and you're done. And they also give the option of a wooden, not wood, but paint. It's plastic, and it's got wood grain. You can paint it wood color. Or whatever color you want, as a push bar if you so choose, which I will not, because I like to see the grill and everything. But that's the instructions, and it does say Ford police car. Here's the tires you get, and they are black wall on both sides. They are Goodyear, and they're polyglass, and they got a pretty neat tread on them. They gave you four, obviously. Although I shouldn't say obviously, because sometimes I've gotten five tires, and it makes no sense. But anyway, at least I didn't get three. That hasn't happened to me. I guess I'd be surprised if that did, but I guess I wouldn't be too surprised if it did as well. There's a couple parts falling off the chrome tree here. So you got your front and rear bumpers. You got the headlights molded in. I don't really care for that, but I mean, it's not the end of the world. At least they do give you separate taillights and the red plastic. We'll get to those in a second. And they give you some bunch of chrome parts on here that I think almost none of these should be chrome at all, maybe with the exception of the roof rack and the mirrors and the hubcaps. Probably everything else should be just regular plastic so you can paint it, because that's probably what I'll end up doing with most of it. Especially with it being a cop car. Here's your metal axles and the screws that you put the wheels and then screw the body together with. I do kind of like that feature because, especially if you have a vehicle that doesn't quite want to go together when you put the body to the chassis, sometimes the screws will squeeze it together enough that you don't have to worry about it. So you get two blue lights and two red lights, and then they give you, for some reason, they give you four taillights here. I'm looking through the package. I'm not seeing any difference at all. I don't know why they give you four. And then four little red lenses for something. And then your one-piece windshield. So let's get all the white parts out here. Like I said, not a whole lot of them, but enough to make a nicely detailed kit. Now here's your wheels. One of them fell off. You can see they're just a one piece with the spoke sticking out the back where you stick the axle in, so it's not even like a two-piece front and back wheel at all. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but, that's kind of like I said, that you're getting into, like, toy car territory there when you're getting, engineering like that. But I understand why, because it was probably also released as a toy with the less parts and the promo. Makes them easier to build. You got your other reels on here. You got a radiator hose, a couple of engine parts, and a real small radiator. Here's your seat. It's your typical bench seat. Got a little bit of flash on it. Not the end of the world. Here's the back part of the back seat. Your hood, which has no detail underneath at all. And here's that engine blanking plug, if you so choose to build it that way. And here's your push bumper, firewall, some more engine parts. Here's your shotgun. It looks like maybe the center console for the interior here. I'm not sure what a couple of these other little parts are. Here's your dashboard. It's a nice little dashboard. No decals for the dash at all, so everything you're going to have to paint by hand in there. Here's your steering wheel. And your exhaust with the rear suspension and rear axle all built into one piece, and the drive shaft. Better than it being molded into the floor pan, but not as good as, you know, a lot of separate pieces. And these look like pretty much all engine parts and your battery. I find it funny how many different variations you get with between model kits and model companies. Now, I know there are different size batteries in real life, but for the most part, they're kind of around the same size, give or take. And some batteries in cars and models, they're just like twice the size of this, and now you get this tiny one. Sometimes it just doesn't make sense to me. How is it all 1/25th scale if one is like three times the size of the other one? And it's a, you know, same era car, which would usually probably have a sort of the same era or the same size battery. Here's your chassis pan. Your interior would obviously sit in here, so you don't see any of this. You will see the interior or the inner fender wells here when you open the hood. Not any detail whatsoever in there. You do have some detail underneath, like your gas tank and your trunk floor. Not sure what the heck this giant bar is here. Doesn't make much sense. And not a whole lot of detail there. Here's your holes where the screws go in. And last but not least, you got your interior bucket with the very lightly imprinted door panels. I mean, there's details there, but it's so faint that it'd kind of really be hard to pick it out. And then you've got your seat and carpet. Both have different textures to them. This, you know, it has like a probably supposed to be cloth texture, and obviously carpet molded in. And your body. You got a couple of braces here, which have already broken. Luckily, the pillars are not broken. It's a sedan, so you've got door pillars here on both sides. And it's a four-door. Not a whole heck of a lot more to it. Here's back here, it is does say Galaxy across the trunk. Molded in, and that is about the only emblem on the car that I see. I don't see anything else. There's the front part. But, you know, once you get done doing your detail and stuff, it should look pretty good. It does have a body molding down the side here. It also looks like, I'm not sure if this is supposed to be a molding around here, but it looks like it could almost have a vinyl top on it, even though there's no texture to it, the way that they've put a molding all the way around the C-pillar there. That's about it. So, we'll get to building it and come back with an update. Okay, so how about we do an update on the 1970 Galaxy 500 police car? And yes, I did determine that it is a 1970 model by looking up the Ford models online, and this is indeed a 1970. And so, let's see. So, we're getting pretty close, actually. And we have the taillights detailed and inserted into the bumper. And we have mostly finished detailing the grill. I have to do a couple little fine touches on there, like the turn signals and a couple of things like the emblem. We're working on the light bar. This is what we got done so far. And I've got the, I originally done a blue and a red lens for the top, but in looking up some pictures, the state troopers in New York, I didn't see any with blue and red, but all the pictures I could find going back were all red and red, so I swapped the blue lens over for the red one. They give you two of each, so, you know, because there's options that you can do on there. I've got the body semi-painted. I've got the yellow done. I didn't have to tape this off, but I just did it so I didn't have, like, way too many coats of paint on this thing. So I'm going to give this a quick sand down here and then tape off the yellow. I forgot to tape off the trunk. I'm going to paint the trunk blue as well. I did paint the hood, but I had a problem. I think it was the primer that I used. A viewer had mentioned, or maybe it was on a Facebook group, I can't remember, recommended me use the automotive primer. And I had reservations about using that. I have some. And it started to, like, crinkle and stuff on me. I don't know why, but it was not a pleasant experience. So it the hood went back into the dunk tank. Luckily, it didn't really happen with the yellow here. I don't know why, what the difference is, because I used the same primer. But anyhow, maybe difference in the paint. I mean, the blue is Rust-Oleum, which is the same brand as the primer, but this was a tester's yellow. It's the same one I used on the 65 Lincoln Continental. I figured, you know, why waste paint if I can use it instead of trying to find, you know, some other oddball color that I might never use again. So on the chassis, I have finished basically the interior and the chassis with the engine. And here you got to look at that. That came out pretty good. No real issues in fit and anything there. Got both axles and they turn. I picked out the exhaust, obviously. Oh, no, wait, no, exhaust was separate pieces. What am I talking about? The only thing I really picked out on here was the straps on the gas tank. I didn't feel like painting the gas tank silver. So, that's about it on there. And I detailed up the hubcaps there. I mean, you'll see that in the reveal anyway, but... And the interior, I thought it came out pretty nice. What I did on this was, as you can see, there's like kind of shiny spots and matte spots. Well, I painted the whole thing flat black. And what I did was I took the Pledge Future Floor Polish stuff and I gave it one coat on the flat black. So it looked like vinyl with cloth inserts for the seats. I thought that came out pretty good. And then underneath, or not underneath, but in the dash part here. Actually, the dash part was pretty easy to detail, even though it didn't come up with any decals or anything. In fact, let me zoom in there so you can maybe get a better look now, because it's probably be the last chance you get to see it. Because once it's in the car, it kind of disappears. And it's hard to see that stuff. So, if I can keep this in focus. So you can see I put fire extinguisher down there in front of the passenger seat. And I wish this would stay in focus. I did the radio in the center. Now, this is, I did run into an issue here. Let me back this up a little bit. It doesn't seem to want to stay in focus that close. The seat has pins where it's supposed to locate, and the dash has locating tabs, and then you've got the hump where the little center console with the computer, or the computer, the radios go. Well, that interferes with the dash, and I could not get those things to sit in there unless I pushed the seat way back, which looked kind of stupid because the seat was like almost up against the back seat then. And it's right now it's in the position where it's supposed to be, where it's designed to be. So what I ended up doing was I shaved the front of the little console that the radios sit on so it could fit closer to the seat. And then I kind of shaved the corner off of one of the radios where it kind of butts up against the dash. You can see it still sits a little cockeyed, but we'll say like that was the intention. Anyway, so, and I painted the microphone white, and then a white cord, which I kind of blackwashed a little bit. And then over here on the other side, you've got a spotlight, which I painted. I left the spotlight chrome, but I painted the cord white, just so it stand out more. I mean, normally I probably would have painted it black, but since I'm doing a black interior, it would have kind of just disappeared in there. So I painted it as, because sometimes, you know, you've seen those squirrely, twirly cords in, you know, different colors. So I figured white and black were probably the most common color that it might end up being. So in order for it to show up, I did it that. And you can see the shotgun, rifle, whatever you want to call it, up here. There's a little chrome lock bracket that is mounted to the dash, and then I detailed the gun with the brown, and then I just painted the metal parts black. So I didn't do a whole lot of detail on the sides. There wasn't like much to do on the door panels there, so I just like pulled some of the handles and emblems out. Then there's not even any like door or there's not even any window cranks or anything like that mounted in, and I don't see any thing saying that it has power windows, which probably didn't. So it's just a lack of effort on the original designers. And you know, I did do some wood grain on the dashboard there. Like I said, it's a little hard to see all this stuff, but I'm doing the best I can to show you. So anyway, basically there's not a whole lot left to do. You've got the glass has to go in, and then the brackets for the light bar, a couple of antennas. You've got an external spotlight, the rear view, two rear view mirrors, one for the side and one for the glass, and the decals that I'm going to put on. So that's where we are. So you're looking at all the parts that are left to go on this. So far, the only issue is what I've pointed out. Nothing else, really. So stay tuned. All right, then. So welcome to the reveal of the Ford Interceptor police car. Basically, what we have here since the update is there really wasn't any issues. Amazingly, for the age of this kit, you know, the design, which I'm sure goes back to when the car was new, 1970. It didn't have a whole lot of building problems. I did forget one thing, which you probably wouldn't notice unless I pointed it out, is I totally forgot to put the inside rearview mirror in when I was putting in the glass in the interior. It got a little ahead of myself, but you know, it is what it is. It's not that noticeable. And so there was really, like I said, no issues putting this together. The decals went on pretty well. All the parts went together really well. It screws together on the bottom, and that all fit together really nice. I mean, I really, honestly, I have no complaints that wise. I mean, just a few minor ones, like there was no locating holes for like the radio antenna or the spotlight or the side view mirror or the roof rack or the side antenna. Now I realize some of those are options, and that's probably why they didn't include holes, but they didn't even include dummy holes from the back where you can open them, so I had to super glue most of that stuff on. But I did actually drill little holes for these two so that I could mount them, because they did come with them. pegs. Pretty decent kit, actually, for its limitations. They didn't give you any license plate brackets, so what I did was the old, what they actually recommend on a lot of models, which I never do, is I just cut them out of the decal sheet, and I just glued them on with the, I just used some of this stuff, this Eileen's tacky glue. Seems to be holding, so I guess it's okay. I mean, I guess I could have used super glue or whatever. So what I'll do is I'll just lower the camera down to a different angle so that you can see the car a little bit better than from up this bird's eye view here. So let's do that, and we'll be done. And thanks for watching.
Man with a gun. One Adam 12, no warrant. Lincoln X-ray.